Aloha, I'm Ramina Van Dyken, MD from Out of the Doldrums. There is a gas that smells just like rotten eggs, hydrogen sulfide. It may smell pretty nasty, but did you know that this rotten egg smelling gas, hydrogen sulfide or H2S, actually plays a vital role in our overall health? In this video, we'll explore the world of H2S, how it functions as a gasotransmitter, and how it benefits our body by doing so. By the way, a gasotransmitter is just a fancy name for a molecule that's in the form of a gas that helps cells communicate with one another. At the end of the video, we'll discuss practical ways that we can balance H2S production and function in our bodies. If you haven't already noticed, throughout this video, I'm going to refer to hydrogen sulfide as H2S. A lot less of a mouthful and easier to say. Don't worry, we'll keep most everything simple and focus on practical applications for you health enthusiasts out there. Before I get started though, let's just remind everybody that the dose makes the poison. Yes, hydrogen sulfide is a poisonous gas. While low doses can be good for our health, high doses of hydrogen sulfide can be lethal. The dose amount of hydrogen sulfide that we talk about in this video are very, very small, minuscule. We're not talking about doses of hydrogen sulfide that you would, for example, see in a manufacturing plant or near a volcano. So use some common sense. Don't go trying to find or inhale hydrogen sulfide gas, okay? Also, while I am a doctor, I'm not your doctor, so keep that in mind during this video. Okay, good. Now that we got that out of the way, let's get started. So what is hydrogen sulfide and what is its role as a gasotransmitter? Hydrogen sulfide is a colorless, smelly gas produced naturally in our bodies. It belongs to a group of molecules called gasotransmitters, which help our cells communicate with each other. There are two other very famous gasotransmitters in our body. Can you guess them? They're nitric oxide, NO, and carbon monoxide, CO. H2S is involved in various essential physiological processes, such as blood vessel relaxation, nerve signaling, and cell production. So, what are some of the health benefits of hydrogen sulfide? Let's break it down. Health benefit number one, blood pressure regulation. Like nitric oxide, H2S helps relax our blood vessels, which can lower blood pressure and promote healthy circulation. So H2S primarily acts as a vasodilator. Vasodilators are substances that help relax and widen blood vessels, which in turn allows blood to flow more easily and reduces blood pressure. So how exactly does this happen? Well, H2S is produced in the cells that line the blood vessels, called endothelial cells, as well as smooth muscle cells, which form the walls of blood vessels. When H2S is released, smooth muscle cells relax, leading to the widening of blood vessels and ultimately a reduction in blood pressure. Additionally, H2S has been shown to enhance the production of nitric oxide, my fave, another important vasodilator and gasotransmitter. NO, or nitric oxide, also contributes to relaxation of blood vessels and helps maintain healthy blood pressure levels, so they kind of work in tandem. By the way, if you're interested in nitric oxide, I have an entire slew of videos all about the molecule and why it's so awesome. They're linked in the description below. But at the end of the day, H2S is nitric oxide's partner in crime, if you know what I mean. They work together to achieve vascular health. So several studies have demonstrated the blood pressure lowering effects of H2S. For instance, a deficiency in H2S production has been linked to hypertension or high blood pressure in both animal models and humans. On the other hand, supplementation with H2S donors or precursors has been shown to lower blood pressure in hypertensive animals. Health benefit number two, brain health. As a neuromodulator, H2S plays a role in maintaining proper brain function and protecting neurons from damage. It does this in a myriad of ways, so let's quickly review them. H2S has antioxidant properties, which can help protect neurons from oxidative damage. By scavenging reactive oxygen species, or ROS, and upregulating the expression of antioxidant enzymes, H2S can reduce oxidative stress in the brain, contributing to overall brain health. H2S also has anti-inflammatory effects. By reducing neuroinflammation, H2S can help protect neurons from damage and maintain brain function. H2S can influence mitochondrial function in neurons too. It does this by regulating mitochondrial respiration and ATP production. Maintaining proper mitochondrial function is crucial for neuron health and energy metabolism. In addition to the mechanisms we just discussed, H2S has been shown to regulate something called autophagy, which is a cellular process that helps clear damaged or dysfunctional cellular components, and apoptosis, which is programmed cell death. This promotes neuronal survival and prevents excessive neuronal loss in the brain. I know that was a lot of science, but it's good. Health benefit number 3, anti-inflammatory properties. So we already kind of touched on this. H2S has been found to reduce inflammation in the body, which can be beneficial for managing chronic inflammatory conditions. In this way, it plays a key role in regulating inflammation and the immune response. These anti-inflammatory properties of H2S has been shown to be beneficial in various inflammatory diseases, including cardiovascular diseases, arthritis, asthma, and inflammatory bowel diseases, and also in neuroinflammatory conditions. Health benefit number 4, cellular protection. H2S can protect our cells from damage caused by oxidative stress, which is important for overall health and preventing diseases related to aging. Okay, so now that we know how hydrogen sulfide benefits our health, what can we do to boost our H2S levels naturally? Here's some tips. The first tip is diet. Consuming foods rich in sulfur-containing amino acids can help increase H2S production in the body. These are either foods that act as H2S donors or foods that promote the production of H2S in our own body. We call this endogenous production. What types of food are we really talking about here? Well, garlic, onions, cruciferous vegetables, and legumes. So garlic, let's start with that. Garlic contains organosulfur compounds such as diallyl trisulfide, diallyl disulfide, and allicin, and all those act as H2S donors. These compounds are thought to contribute to the health benefits of garlic, such as its antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, and vasodilator properties. Onions, similar to garlic, onions contain organosulfur compounds that can promote H2S production. Onions are also rich in compounds such as S-allylcysteine and S-methylcysteine, which can serve as a substrate for H2S-producing enzymes in the body. Moving on to cruciferous vegetables. Vegetables like broccoli, Brussels sprouts, cabbage, and cauliflower contain sulfur-containing compounds called glucosinolates. When these vegetables are consumed and broken down by the enzymes in our body, they form compounds like isothiocyanates, which can contribute to H2S production. How about legumes? Beans, lentils, and chickpeas, those are all rich in sulfur-containing amino acids, such as cysteine and methionine. These amino acids can serve as precursors for H2S production when metabolized by H2S-producing enzymes. Another food that increases the availability of H2S that we already have in our body is green tea. Specifically, green tea contains a class of chemicals called catechins. We lovingly refer to these as EGCG. This catechin catalytically oxidizes hydrogen sulfide, which allows the H2S to act in different areas of the body. So that's how we use food and diet to increase H2S levels. Number 2, exercise. So regular exercise has been shown to stimulate H2S production, which may contribute to its many health benefits. When we exercise, more H2S is made in the cells of the blood vessel walls, the endothelium. This H2S dilates the blood vessels by relaxing the smooth muscle cells and blood vessel walls. This improves blood flow and oxygen delivery to the working muscles and other tissues, which all in all improves exercise performance and endurance. The third way is supplements. Some supplements, such as N-acetylcysteine, NAC, and alpha-lipoic acid, or ALA, can increase the availability of sulfur-containing molecules in the body, potentially boosting H2S levels. Number 4, be mindful of medications. Some medications, like non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, or NSAIDs, can reduce H2S production. So NSAIDs, they're a class of medications we commonly use to relieve pain, reduce inflammation, and lower fever. NSAIDs work by inhibiting the activity of the COX enzymes, or cyclooxygenase enzymes, which play a crucial role in the synthesis of prostaglandins, which are substances involved in inflammation and pain signaling. So long story short, H2S and COX pathways are intertwined, and their interactions can influence each other. So if COX enzymes are inhibited, H2S production can be decreased. So there you have it. Hydrogen sulfide, the gas with a notorious smell, turns out to be a crucial player in maintaining our health. By understanding its role as a gasotransmitter and adopting some simple lifestyle changes, we can harness the power of H2S to improve our well-being. Thanks for watching, and I hope this video helps you on your individual health journey. If you found this video helpful or useful to you, give it a thumbs up. If you want to show us some real support, subscribe. Until next time, cherish your health and aloha.